Okay, Jesus, you ain't come to play with him. Oh, Keisha. What's up, Keisha?
What you doing, girl?
No, just reading the Bible.
Girl, did you hear about Isla?
No, what happened?
How about she in the hospital?
In a hospital? Why?
The doctor's got to do surgery on her eyes.
Surgery on her eyes? Okay, why? What's wrong with them?
Girl, you ain't hear this from me, but how about she tried to pluck one of them out?
Girl, you lying to me. Okay, run that back.
All I know, it was something about a fine man lusting and something about the scriptures.
Okay, that's not what the scripture meant. It didn't mean for you to... Help the Lord.
Girl, I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, okay then. Alright then. Well, thanks for telling me, girl.
No problem.
Alright, later. Jesus. If Lena on your own understanding was a person. Howdy, how y'all doing today? My name is Tay, and welcome back to my channel, Inspire Me, where I talk about current or relatable topics, all from a godly perspective. And today's topic is called, If Not Leaning to Your Own Understanding Was a Person. Now, the reason why I thought about this, I think I read this and I was like, okay, this would be a good scenario. Now, the go-to scripture I wanted to use is actually going to be Matthew 18 chapter, verse 8-9. It reads, if your hand or foot causes you to sin, cut it off and cast it from you. It is better for you to enter into life maimed, rather than having two hands and two feet to be cast into the everlasting fire. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out and cast it from you. It is better for you to enter into life with one eye rather than having two eyes to be cast into hellfire. Now, when I first heard this scripture a few years ago, probably like a teenager, I read, I was like, I know God's not saying to literally pluck your eye out. Even though I didn't really know the true meaning of the scripture, but I just knew that God was not saying literally pluck your eyes out. But as I came more to God, I realized when that scripture says, do not lead to your understanding, because sometimes we can read stuff in the Bible and we think it's one way and it's like, God say, okay, that's not what it meant. That's why you should ask me. That's what God be saying. So after I got like the true meaning of this scripture. Now, say for instance, if you have a desire or appetite to look at certain type of, I'm just saying, a man look at a woman. You like a woman that's curvy, a nice shape, and that's something that, you know, it could be you could have a wife or you could be single. At the end of the day, lust is lust. It doesn't matter if you're married or not married. So, say for instance, if you see this person and you look at them like, ooh, I want that. You all drooling out the mouth and stuff. Now, what God is not saying to literally pluck your eye out so you can't see the person. Because if you look at it, even if a person did actually pluck their eyes out, don't you know a person can be blind and they still could think about the individual in their head? Okay, what about a person that watches, I'm not going to say it, but you know, and even though they don't have a actual person, you know, like I said, but you don't have to actually see the person, have eyes to see the person to sin. You can literally think about the person in your mind and still be sinning. What you gonna do, pluck your mind out? In that case, you gonna be gone from this earth. you know what I mean. God's not saying that. He's not also saying, okay, when they say pluck your cut your hand off, your one hand off or your foot, one foot off, even if you cut off one hand or one foot, you can still do stuff with the other hand. You can still do stuff with the other foot. That don't mean nothing.
Yeah, I had to move locations. I know a person that was born with no arms. And they could pretty much do everything by themselves. They could drive, they could cook. They could do all that. So, what that means, because you cut off one hand. Or you cut off one foot. Even if a person did cut off both of them, they still could do some. I think he's even a preacher, if I'm not mistaken. He don't have legs or hands, and he's still preaching the word, so you don't need a literal limbs in order to do certain things that is right or righteous. So God's not saying, oh, cut off this, oh, cut off that, pluck out your eye. What he's saying is, okay, say for instance, like I said, with a scenario, if a person sees a person that they're attracted to and it's causing you to pretty much sin and lust, close your eyes. You can easily close your eyes without plucking it, but also that mind, even if a person closes their eyes, it can still be in their mind. That's when you gotta ask God to renew your mind. Okay, if you thinking about lust, how about go to another room and then open up your Bible? If you see somebody on the street and they looking good, why not go around the corner or turn around and pray? Why not ask God to help you deal with that lust so you don't have it no more? So when you do see a person that look fine or whatever the case might be, it don't bother you no more when you see them. That's what God is referring to. Not to literally pluck your eye. Not to literally cut your hands off. Not to literally cut your feet off. But at the end of the day, just because you pluck your eye out doesn't mean that you're more righteous, because you can still think it in your mind. So many times in our past where it wasn't good to God's eyesight, because a lot of things I said was in my mind, and a lot of things I said was not righteous. But of course, people on the outside, if they, let's say, had like the sermon or something like that, they didn't know. But God knew. So just because a person put their eyes out doesn't mean that they're more holier than a person who have two eyes. Because a person who have two eyes could be more righteous. So don't think just because you pluck your eye out, don't do that, please, y'all. That's what God's saying. He's not saying that. Like I said, in the scenarios, close your eyes, go around the corner, and then don't just do that. Try to replace it with something that God says. Reading the word, fasting, praying to God. That's pretty much, that's what clarification God gave to me. Now, we got to stop leaning on our own understanding, stop thinking that the Bible means one thing when clearly it doesn't. Just like in the Bible, I said in another video, probably two, when God says fear him. Now, he's not referring to the fear like fearing man and, oh, I'm trembling, I'm so scared of God. No, he's not referring to that. He's referring to respect him, honor him. When you in his presence, when he in the midst, when you come to his throne of grace, you respect him. You don't talk to him like a little homeboy or a little homegirl. I hear so many people say, oh, that's my dog, that's my bruh, or that's my homeboy. No, Jesus is our Heavenly Father. Respect him. Fear him. That's what fear means. Not trembling. Not a little scared. But yeah, that type of fear. Respect him. So yeah, that's pretty much all I had to say regarding that. If there's something that you don't have clarification about, and yeah, you lack understanding regarding the scriptures, ask God. And don't leave his midst or whatever until you keep seeking about it. That's pretty much all I had to say. And also too, I wanted to say, I think a couple of videos back, when I was saying discernment is not given to, who's not born again. Now, I'm not sure regarding it, like, just disregard that part, because I don't know. I don't want to give you false information regarding that. I don't know. I just know when you have a gut feeling, that's God talking to you. If you feel something in your gut, whether you take heed or not, even if you don't have the discernment, it's God trying to talk to you. So that's like discernment. So like I said, I don't know if God give discernment to people who are not born again, or if it's called something else. But yeah, I don't want to give you the wrong information regarding that. So yeah, that's pretty much all I had to say today. Make sure you like, make sure you share, and also make sure you subscribe to my channel. Y'all have a blessed day.